welcome to Learning English, a daily 30-minute program from the Voice of America. I'm Ashley Thompson.
And I'm Mario Ritter, Jr. This program is designed for English learners, so we speak a little slower and we use words and phrases especially written for people learning English.
On today's program, you will hear stories from Anna Mateo, Andrew Smith, and John Russell. Later, Bryan Lynn presents this week's technology report. Finally, we continue our national parks journey with a visit to Joshua Tree National Park in California. But first,
new research shows that water temperatures in and around Australia's Great Barrier Reef have risen to their warmest in 400 years, over the past 10 years. The rising temperatures have put the world's largest reef under threat. The Great Barrier Reef is the world's largest living ecosystem. It stretches for 2,400 kilometers off the coast of the northern state of Queensland. A group of scientists at universities across Australia removed core samples from the coral. They examined the samples to measure summer ocean temperatures going back to the year 1618. The scientists combined information from core samples with ship and satellite data going back around 100 years. The results show that ocean temperatures were unchanged for hundreds of years. But starting in 1900, the ocean temperatures began to rise. The research found that this is the result of human influence. From 1960 to 2024, the study's writers observed an average yearly warming for January to March of 0.12 degrees Celsius per decade. Since 2016, the reef has experienced 5 summers of mass coral bleaching. This is when large parts of the reef turn white due to heat stress. This also puts the coral at greater risk of death. The mass bleaching events happened during 5 of the 6 warmest years in the last 4 centuries, the study showed. This research appeared on August 8th in the publication Nature. The world is losing one of its icons, said Benjamin Henley. He is with the University of Melbourne and is one of the study's co-writers. I find that to be an absolute tragedy. It's hard to understand how that can happen on our watch in our lifetime. So it's very sad, Henley added. The last temperature measurement from January to March of this year was the highest on record. Henley added that it was head and shoulders above any other year, meaning it was much higher. Coral reefs are important for many reasons. They protect shorelines from erosion. They are home to thousands of kinds of fish. And they are an important part of the tourism industry in many countries. In Australia, the Great Barrier Reef adds 4.2 billion to the economy each year. At least 54 countries and areas have experienced mass bleaching of their reefs since February 2023, as climate change warms the ocean's surface waters. That information comes from the U.S. National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. I'm Ana Mateo.
In the green hills of central Bosnia and Herzegovina, Halim Zukic has recreated a nature park in the form of one of Vincent van Gogh's most famous paintings, The Starry Night. Zukic is from the town of Visoko. He decided to create a park after buying some land and a small house in a nearby village 20 years ago. But he had no clear idea of what the park should look like. Then he saw tractors moving among fields of tall grass 6 years ago. He also saw that the tractors made circular shapes in the earth. This reminded him of similar shapes in Van Gogh's painting. "From that moment, I was no longer in doubt," Zukic told Reuters news agency. But his effort took him time, money, and a lot of work. To match the painting, Zukic brought in 130,000 lavender plants in six colors. Plants known for their aromas and medicinal uses were also planted. These include sage, echinacea, wormwood, and chamomile. Together, they form colorful circles and help recreate the appearance of Van Gogh's painting. Zukic also planted more trees and created 13 small lakes using water from the area. Zukic did the work to form the land into the same shape as the painting by himself. He said recreating the painting has helped him better understand artists and the creative problems they face. This is the largest representation of The Starry Night and the result of 20 years of dreams, of living those dreams to make them real, he said. The park is 10 hectares in size. Zukic said it will show art programs and promote Central Bosnia's cultural heritage. Zukic also wants the park to offer visitors a place to rest and think. Van Gogh was born in 1853 in the Netherlands and died in 1890 in France. I'm Andrew Smith.
The famous street artist known as Banksy recently announced a new painting on another wall along a street in London. The image is of a rhinoceros that appears to be climbing on top of a real car parked in front of the mural. The work is part of a new series of animal-centered murals that Banksy has created in the British capital. The collection includes paintings of elephants, a goat, a wolf, pelicans, and more. The secretive artist, who has never confirmed his official identity, has been announcing the new work on his Instagram social media page. One of the pieces shows a group of the sharp-toothed fish called piranhas. That piece was painted on a police emergency call box near the Central Criminal Court, known as the Old Bailey. A small crowd of people gathered near that artwork recently, taking photographs as some city workers placed barriers around it. A spokesman for the city government said it is considering how to preserve the work. Another recent work is of pelicans eating fish. The mural was painted above the sign of a fish market in East London. Another Banksy painting appeared on a satellite dish. It showed a wolf, mouth open and head pointed up, as if howling. However, that artwork did not remain in place long. A video posted online shows three men removing the piece and carrying it away hours after Banksy announced its existence. Banksy began his career by spray painting buildings in Bristol, England. He has since become one of the world's best-known artists. His work has sold for millions of dollars. I'm John Russell.
Some common mistakes in English happen when speakers confuse adjectives and adverbs. Some adverbs look the same but have opposite meanings. Do not fear. Tomorrow's Everyday Grammar lesson will help sort it all out for you. Learn why ly at the end of a word usually, but not always, tells you it is an adverb. Listen to our podcast tomorrow, or visit our website to learn more, learningenglish.voanews.com.
Google has added a new tool that permits Android users to create digital versions of many kinds of identification ID cards and event passes for device wallets. The tool is part of the Google Wallet app. It was first announced in May along with other changes to the latest operating system, Android 15. The change is explained on a Google Wallet Help website. The tool is now available for Android users in the United States who have the latest update of Google Wallet. Digital wallets are designed to permit users to save non-physical versions of credit cards, personal IDs, membership passes, and event tickets to their smartphones or other devices. Credit cards in wallets are linked directly to the banks that offer them and can be used to pay for things just like with a physical credit card. The use of digital wallets has expanded over the years as people depend more on digital IDs and other documents. Supporters say this reduces the need to carry a lot of cards in a physical wallet. Until now, Google Wallet divided its digital document offerings into categories. Examples of these categories would be payment or gift cards, transportation passes for bus, train, or air travel, as well as official IDs. Google's new tool is designed to permit device users to easily add many more kinds of documents to its wallet service. These could include the kinds of passes many people carry in their physical wallets, such as gym memberships and medical or insurance cards. These digital versions can be created by the user taking a picture of the physical document or by doing a screen capture of a digital version from a device. Some documents have an electronic barcode or QR code that can be entered into the wallet app. Google Wallet then uses artificial intelligence, AI technology, to use information from the photo to create a new digital pass. The process of creating these digital documents is similar to adding new documents to Google Wallet. Users open the app and then click on Add to Google Wallet. The app then gives users a choice of what kind of card or pass to create. These include groups like payment card, transit pass, or ID card. The new Google Wallet has a new category called Everything Else. This offering was created to permit users to make digital copies of just about any card, pass, or document they want to keep in their devices. Google offers additional security steps to users storing official documents on Android devices. These private passes can also be added to Google Wallet. Google says data contained in official digital documents is only saved on the device as an extra security measure. People in some American states can create a digital ID to be used to officially prove their identity. Google explains that this service is currently only available in Arizona, Colorado, Georgia, and Maryland. There is a process users must follow to have their digital IDs verified by each state. The Transportation Security Administration, TSA, even accepts this form of state ID at many major U.S. airports. Online technology website Android Authority recently reported Google Wallet will soon be equipped to also create digital versions of American passports. To create this official digital document, users would need to be holders of a U.S. government-issued e-passport. The online publication said one of its writers discovered the Google Wallet passport is still in development at Google. Android Authority noted that having a passport saved in Google Wallet might remove the need to present an actual passport in some cases. However, the digital version is not designed to replace the physical passport, which the user should continue to carry. I'm Bryan Lynn.
Bryan Lynn joins me now to talk more about his technology report. Hi, Bryan. Thanks for being here.
Of course, Ashley. Thank you for having me.
This week's report dealt with changes Google recently made to its Wallet app. The changes permit users to create more kinds of digital IDs and other cards. I know you mentioned possible privacy issues in the report, but should users be concerned about whether these apps are secure?
So, of course, this can be an issue whenever personal data is entered online or in device apps. One privacy measure mentioned in the report was Google saying that any information entered in the process of creating digital IDs is only stored on the device itself, not company servers or in the cloud. This means the data can also be removed at any time by the device owner. And Google also provides more in-depth information on the kinds of data it may collect for Wallet, as well as the ways it handles that data in its official privacy policies published online.
The report also states that Google uses new AI technology to help create the digital documents. What can you tell us about that?
Yes, so in the past, Google provided a drop-down list for users seeking to create digital IDs and passes on their devices. These were specific categories for different things. The new tool, though, just creates the digital versions automatically from a photo or screen capture users choose. And Google said the AI it has been developing, which it calls Gemini, made these new wallet changes possible. The AI systems are used to examine the entered data and then find the best way to organize it into a presentable digital document. And the company says it plans to continue to improve these AI tools for use with Wallet and its other app offerings as well.
All right. Thanks again for joining me, Bryan, and thank you for your technology report.
You're welcome, Ashley. Thank you.
VOA Learning English has launched a new program for children. It is called Let's Learn English with Anna. The new course aims to teach children American English through asking and answering questions and experiencing fun situations. For more information, visit our website, learningenglish.voanews.com. On our national parks journey, we explore a unique place where two deserts meet. The hot, harsh, rocky landscape is home to a rare and strange-looking tree. In fact, the park gets its name from this iconic plant. Welcome to Joshua Tree National Park in southeastern California. The limbs of Joshua trees stretch and twist upward in all directions. At the end of each limb are sharply pointed green leaves. The plant looks like a large cactus and can grow over 12 meters tall. But as the National Park Service explains, Joshua trees are not really even trees. They are succulents that belong to the yucca family. Succulents are desert plants that can hold a lot of water inside them. Joshua trees are not exactly beautiful. An early explorer to the area once described them as the most repulsive tree in the vegetable kingdom. But park visitors are amazed by the wild-looking forests of Joshua trees.
The Mormon religious group is said to have given the plant its name. Mormon settlers reportedly thought it looked like the Christian holy figure Joshua, his arms held out, guiding travelers to the Promised Land. Joshua trees thrive in the climate of the Mojave, one of two deserts within the park. The Mojave is a high desert. It is 900 meters above sea level. It is also relatively cool and wet. The Mojave Desert meets up here with the Colorado Desert. The Colorado is a lower desert. It makes up the eastern part of the national park. Much of the park sits within the overlap of the two deserts. The overlap creates a diverse ecosystem where many plants and animals thrive.
Within the park, you can find bighorn sheep, desert tortoises, iguanas, and black-tailed jackrabbits. The park is also home to 250 kinds of birds, like the red-tailed hawk, the roadrunner, and the Scots oriole. After spring rainstorms, desert wildflowers burst to life in colorful display. The blooms on Joshua trees are bright white. Cacti produce bright purple, red, and orange wildflowers. The blooms last just a few weeks before the hot summer heat becomes too strong. Along with Joshua trees, large piles of rocks are another defining part of the park's landscape. The huge boulders sit stacked on top of each other. Roads and hiking trails lead visitors through paths of these boulders.
Joshua Tree National Park is over 320,000 hectares. It has many hiking and walking trails, from long hikes that take all day to finish to short ones, like the Hidden Valley Trail. This trail takes you through an area that was once a place for cattle-stealing cowboys to hide out. The area's massive rock piles made for effective places to hide in the desert. These huge boulder piles and rock walls have made Joshua Tree National Park world famous for rock climbing and bouldering. The park has more than 8,000 climbing routes. John Hackhausler often comes to Joshua Tree to rock climb and enjoy nature. He makes the 3-hour drive from Los Angeles, where he is a lawyer.
When you see the park from down low, it's beautiful, but when you see the park from 150, 200 feet up, it's amazing.
Renate Ehrlich visited the national park with Hackhausler. She is also a lawyer in Los Angeles. She had just tried rock climbing at Joshua Tree for the first time.
We love it. We come here to walk on trails. Last time we were here, we rode jeeps, which was so much fun. And it's just a great place. Great outdoorsy place. It's a lot of character.
I'm Caty Weaver.
And I'm Ashley Thompson. That's our program for today. Join us again tomorrow to keep learning English through stories from around the world. I'm Ashley Thompson.
And I'm Mario Ritter Jr.